Welcome back. In the last video, we wrote code in the spawn volume that told the spawn volume where to spawn. In this next video, we're going to set up what to spawn, and then finally, after this, we're going to set up when to spawn, and when all those are complete, we'll have a spawn volume that we can set up to basically keep putting pickups into our level for our character to come collect. So just pop that out of the way real quick. And let's get started with the what to spawn. So we're going to use a protected variable. So all subclasses, whether they're code or blueprints, can set what to spawn. But no other class, like the game mode or the character, can change the pickup to spawn. So we're going to use T subclass of. And we could just use a uClass pointer here, but let me just get this entered in. What to spawn. But using T subclass of means that we're able to enforce that only a pickup or any child class, like our battery blueprint or our straight up pickup blueprint, can be set on the what to spawn variable. But because it does behave a lot like a uClass pointer, we can, we've got this for declaration in here, and that still works fine. So this spawn, this is protected, and therefore it can only be set in this class or a child spawn volume classes. What we are going to do is really protect, bad choice of words, we're going to make private the spawn pickup function. We trust the spawn volume to handle the right spawning, but no other classes can. So this is not going to be able to be called from blueprints. Actually, let me just back up a moment, speaking of blueprints, and make this property or this variable have a macro on it. So it's going to be edit anywhere, and again, our category is spawning. So just as we place these volumes in our level, like I said, we're not gonna make this a blueprint in the tutorial series, but you totally could. We just want to be able to edit what to spawn directly on the details panel. So that's why that's edit anywhere. All right, so sorry, back to our spawn pickup. This is going to handle spawning a new pickup, but it is private. It is not going to be able to be called from any other class. And we will go into our spawn volume source file to define that spawn pickup behavior. So it's a void function again. It doesn't return anything, it's just going to spawn our pickups. And I've got a little bit of pseudocode that I'm going to copy in here, and then I'll read through it. It's just sort of the steps that I was thinking through when I was trying to decide what all needed to happen in the spawn pickup function. So if we have set something to spawn, we're going to check for valid world because that's really important, and I'll explain more on that. And then we'll set the spawn parameters and spawn the pickup. And if you notice, this is all under the if, so I'm going to indent that slightly. So how do we check if we've set something to spawn? We've got this if what to spawn is not null, right? Just a good check to make sure that we didn't forget to set what to spawn, because that would really be sort of unexpected behavior for this function. We wouldn't want to try to call it otherwise. So I've moved the bracket, the closing brace for this if statement down below the rest of my pseudocode. Okay, so now we have to check for valid world. And if you've ever had tried to access UWorld and then opened the editor and it's just crashed, this is probably a missing if world check, because there are a lot of things where, you know, you start up the editor and you don't necessarily have a game world the same way that you do when you're actually playing your game or running your project. So it's good to always check for a valid world. And that's just pretty easy to do. This little bit of code here, there's get world already for us to just call and verify. And again, we have another if statement for if world. And the reason we're storing it and not doing just an if get world right in here is that we're going to use world later when we're spawning. World is what uWorld is what contains the general spawn actor function. So again, just going to make this if statement, move the braces down, and then indent this next set of pseudocode. So again, first step, if we have set something to spawn, then continues the next block, check for a valid world, and if both of those are true, then we can start working on the spawn parameters. So just some general parameters. There's actually this structure, fActor spawn parameters. And we're just going to call that spawn params. The owner of what we're spawning is going to be is this. It's just that's sort of some boilerplate to include, and then spawn params instigator is instigator. It's just, so of the things that we're spawning, do they know who owns them? Do they know who caused them to be spawned? Now, the reason we set up the where to spawn in the last video is so that we can use it right here. And we're going to actually add a little bit more of a comment here and get a random location to spawn at. I'm going to do that using fVector, making a new vector called spawn location and setting its value equal to the results from that get random point and volume function that we set up previously. So, whoops. There we go. So, again, we wrote that function up a little bit earlier that was took the origin and the extent and just gave us a random point in our box. And rather than having to repeat that code, because maybe eventually we'd come change the point selector to weight more heavily towards the character or away from the character, and rather than have to come fix the code in multiple places, if we called this function more than one time, we'll just wrap it all up in a function that we can also then call from blueprints. And then we will also get a rotation for the pickups to spawn at. If you've noticed, when I tested earlier with the battery pickup, if it fell straight down, it just kind of sat there and just didn't look as interesting. So we'll just give it a nice random rotation too. So we're going to set up a frotator and call that spawn rotation. Again, it really helps when you're coming back to debug if your variables kind of say what they do, rather than a lot of I and J and this and just plain rotation, that kind of thing. So we're going to set a yaw, fmath. There's already some random functionality built into the math library that you can just use here, multiply it by 360. And just for the interest of time here, it's going to be the same random function for also getting the pitch and the roll. So we've set a spawn rotation and we're doing the yaw, pitch, and roll all with some random rotation, a random value. Finally, we've got spawn the pickup. Now, remember I stored world, so we've got world, spawn actor, a pickup, and then what to spawn, spawn location. And you notice as I'm going through, it's actually highlighting the correct parts of the arguments for me. Spawn actor can actually take a lot of arguments. So say you don't necessarily want to give a rotation, or if you wanted to build your whole transform, you could do that, but I'm giving a spawn location and a rotation separately because I want to just build those. And just in case I want to work with it later, I'm actually going to store this in a store pointer to the spawn pickup. think I want to work with it, but this will just make it easier if I want to. Really quick though, if you noticed, I had to use a pickup here, which means I need to go to the top and include a pickup.h. The reason that I'm including it here in the source file and not here in the spun volume header is that the forward declaration works fine right here. But once I'm actually working with the pickup class directly and might need to know more information about the pickup, that's when I'll include it. This means that if I need to include that spawn volume.h somewhere else, I'm not also bringing along spawn volume, only if, and therefore I'm trying to keep my headers as, you know, separate and delineated as I can. Just go back and check in here. So a pickup, and sometimes you can set, say, other variables to be accessible to be set on spawn, and that's why you really need to know more about a pickup, and that's why you have to include it here. So we can go ahead and compile. Just go ahead and kick that off now, and when we come back in the next video, we will set when to spawn. Thanks!